speaking of the Flyers, earlier today, Chuck Fletcher met with the media to talk about a variety of topics, and that includes next month's trade deadline.
No, I don't expect us to trade a first-round pick for a rental or anything like that. I mean, we could both buy and sell. But I guess my point is, every decision we make, if we're going to try to improve our team going forward, and we can get that player now, great. There's always opportunities. So it's, to me, it's not the next eight games or even the rest of the year. It's from this point forward, we got to get better. And to be better next year, we may have to try to get better this year. So that's what we're trying to do, whether it's the coaches on the ice or adding players or whatever we have to do. But I'm not trading Claude Giroux, that's for sure. Look, they have a lot of good players here, but I'm not. I would never say never to almost anybody besides Giroux. I mean, Giroux's got the no trade, and he's our captain and probably one of the best players in the history of the franchise. So I don't think that makes much sense. But and there's a lot of guys that don't make much sense to trade either, but you can't say never.
Okay, so basically, it's anybody's guess what the Flyers are going to do is what we're saying there. And I like how you mentioned, though, Claude Giroux is untouchable.
I love that he mentioned that because I had a chance to speak to Claude Giroux's agents during the All-Star weekend, and I asked them the same thing. And they said, listen, he's a captain. He loves Philly. Philly's home for him. That's where him and his wife have settled, and that's where he's established himself to be an All-Star once again in this league as he was a couple days ago in San Jose. And right now, Scotty, he's got 52 points in 48 games. He's a +4. And that production rate is so high considering it's been a challenging year for Philly. So he's been great so far this season once again.
Yeah, he's a unique player. He's one that you would not want to trade. You can build around him. Yes, they need to get better in certain areas, but I don't think trading Claude Giroux is going to help this team. They need Claude Giroux in the lineup, but they definitely need to get better defensively. The defense needs some help. They need some help for some secondary scoring on this team. How they do that, I don't know. Chuck Fletcher's been there a while. He's had a chance to survey and see this team, and now it's his chance to make a few moves if he feels are necessary. But it's an interesting team. I mean, they're kind of have a nice mix of old and young, but I just don't know if the young is, they've taken a bit of a step back this year. Nolan Patrick, Goss Despair, Provorov, they have a young defense. They could really use maybe a good veteran presence back there to help solidify this defense and get them going in the right direction again.
No Scotty, question. When you look at that defense, it is so young. So the question is, do you allow them a couple more years to develop, or do you think that they should maybe make a move and try to get something for a Provorov or a Goss Despair?
No, I think I would keep them. I mean, defense are too hard to come by in this league. And Provorov, he's having an off year, Goss Despair a little bit too. But that happens. They're still young. They're still learning their trade. And they don't have a lot of help. I mean, if you would get a veteran guy, if you look at Noah Hanifin for Calgary, he goes from Carolina where he's a number one pick. He's the guy in defense where it was probably too much pressure for him. He's a good hockey player. He's really excelled in Calgary now with Giordano there. And I think they need a veteran presence to just be a mentor for these young guys, to lead them in the right direction and help them take the next step in their careers. But I think defense are way too hard to come by. They got Sam Ran.
Sanheim.
Thank you.
Yep.
And Robert Hägg also. Mm-hmm. So they're a young team. Their future's bright on defense, but I think they just need one solid veteran defenseman that these guys can look up to.
Yeah, I don't disagree with you. I think that makes a lot of sense. I mean, if we looked at teams, and we were talking off camera just about the contending teams, and you look at the contenders, of course, when you're a contender, you're further out along in terms of your curve or the development of the team. But one thing that's consistent, every one of them has a veteran D or two mm-hmm. that can play, that can contribute, but that also can lead. And that can continue to teach and be the example, not by way of talking only, but by way of showing that. Mm-hmm. So if you look at any team that's up in the top of the league, Tampa as an example, you look at what Dan Girardi brings to the table as a veteran guy that's played big games for the Rangers, that's a grit guy that's going to block shots, do some of the unsavory things. And a guy like Sergachev can see that and mm-hmm. can learn and can see that example that he puts forward. So that's one thing that a lot of these teams, if you go back to Pittsburgh when they won the Cup, Ron Hainsey, right. As a part of that group. Trevor Daley, yeah. as a part of that group.
Sure.
Two guys that have played in the league a long time that were still very good contributors, solid and great pros.
And I think what we've learned watching Philly is they really just need a solid goalie. That's always been the question for the last several years. And Carter Hart, they're hoping, is that goalie. Do you think that he could really become that franchise face in the crease?
I definitely do. Listen, I was curious to see how Carter Hart was going to play. I spoke to his agent, Alain Roy, early in the season. I was watching him at the AHL level. I'm like, I'm not really fully seeing it. Since he's come to Philly, this man's locked in. He looks outstanding. Keep in mind, he was playing in the WHL last year for Everett in the WHL, the only two-time CCHL goalie of the year in history, in Canadian junior hockey history. And I'm not one for hype. I'm in the performance business. But this guy's performing. He looks great in the crease. And, James, I know you're trying to soft shoe this question. You try to give me a little softball lob. You were there when we were talking to Claude Giroux. You were talking to him. Weeksy, this guy looks like the real deal. This guy has some Carey Price in him. Love the way he gets to the spots. He's so calm in the net. That's coming from Claude Giroux, their captain, who's had the chance to be in the league and is an all-star, perennial all-star. He knows goalies. He's an offensive guy. When he's telling you that and different people on the team are telling you that, Scotty, they're cooking with Gasser and Philly right now in the net. I love what I've seen from Carter Hart in this sample size.
Finally.
Oh.
Finally. And you're right. Giroux's shooting on this guy in practice. Yeah. He knows what he's up against. So it's great. It's nice to see Carter Hart come in. And he doesn't have a lot of support yet. So this guy's got some really nice numbers and playing great hockey. And he's not going into a system that's really a shutdown defensive system at all. They're a little leaky. They give up a lot of quality shots. So Carter Hart's looking really good, even though he doesn't have that support in the back end.
No question. I like his, one thing quickly. I like his ability to get from point A to point B. He skates exceptionally well, which makes the game seem easy to him. But also, he has that inherent confidence that he's going to make the saves once he gets there. And anytime you're a good first-shot goalie in this league and you can make saves on quality looks, like you were saying, you have the opportunity to be very, very special.
Yeah, looks like there's a high ceiling on this kid. What were you saying?
Yeah, he's very fluent. He's so fluent, and he's always upright. I like when the goalies are always upright and they have their chest up. A lot of goalies, when they push across, they start tipping over. Mm-hmm. He's very coordinated. He stays up, keeps the shoulders square, and that's why he stops a lot of pucks.